Now, let me explain. Revenant is a fictional story I wrote, a dark fantasy fictional story where plague-spreading vampire creatures called Sulkars roam the land of Iceland, renamed as Renoir. Humanity within the land must defend themselves, yet they lacked the proper tools, for they lived in the Dark Age. But through their struggle, innovation arose. Humanity built walls for each district of cities, towns, and villages. And lastly, the Wild Hunt! The Wild Hunt were a society of hunters who dedicate themselves on hunting down every variant and categories of soul crawlers until there is no more but an empty well. With the lore done, it's time for the events and characters. Revenant contains 4 books and each book contains sets of 2 protagonists and antagonists. Let's start off from book 1.
I totally just dropped this. Alright, let's go. Get it done. Cherry bomb.
Revan Rigo is a short-statured and one-eyed law school graduate who is trapped into a hunter, discovered to be a royal-blooded prince, and obligated to deliver the king's 2 sons to a mysterious governess in the northern region. In Revan's journey, he would face Sulkars, the king's men, and must do his best to protect his squad and his adopted little brother, Lupin. And lastly, get his throne back.
Bakers trade bread recipes on a need-to-know basis. Need.
I get it.
A moon rock tastes better than an earthly rock because it's meteor. Oh man, that made me hungry. A backwards poet writes in verse.
Do you even get that?
Of course not. I used to be addicted to soap, but I'm clean now.
Alright, I've actually never heard that one.
Okay, I'm all joked out.
Sham is an amnesiac adolescent girl who does not know her origin and later on found and befriended by Lori, an orphan boy and Sham's first friend. After a horrific event, Sham became dedicated on finding a safe haven for her, Lori, and people she made friends along the way. Both Revan and Sham would cross paths, yet still on their own story and journey.
Ooh, wait a minute. It's you again? Ah, it gets better every time.
And now for the antagonist.
Find her, Captain. I want her alive.
Good work, Captain. Now arrest her.
I'm waiting, Captain. Then drag her outside and...
You think you've outwitted me? But I'm a patient man, and gypsies don't do well inside stone walls.
Alaric Rigo is a corrupted king with a mysterious motive, massacring small villages and towns and drafting people who wronged him into untrained hunters. Revan was one of the people who was drafted, and Alaric would make sure Revan will die and not dethrone him. Alaric's reason and planning of sending his 2 sons under Revan's hands is still unclear and left unsolved.
You dare disobey!
Lavender Graysmith is a governess who lives in the north, living alone and waiting for someone. Her motive is unclear and unsolved. So yeah, Revenant Book 1 is about a prince taking back his throne from the king and a little girl finding a home while a governess waits for an arrival. A prey. Book 2.
You'll be a wise king.
There will never be a wiser king than you. Or a better father. I have much to learn. I know that now. Someday, perhaps, I shall make you proud.
You've already made me proud.
Magdo Rigo is a prince who is led by his father's expectation of becoming a great king. He as well participates the Wild Hunt as a means of helping his people and searching for someone. Nidia reveals a hunter who had gone mad, killing various hunters and Magdil's allies. She says, well, the person Magdil is searching for Nidia is Magdil's twin sister. Nidia won't be the antagonist, nor Magdil will be the hero. Both of them are poised with different motivation that makes them fight against each other. So, Revenant Book 2 is about twins fighting each other due to their differences and motivations. Book 2 is also taking place before Book 1, making the story a prequel. Book 3.
Dead anyway, why would I tell you anything?
Because I can make it quick. Or I can make it so much worse.
Think about what he did. How many people are dead because of him?
Last chance.
I'm not giving up, my friend.
Oh,
Yep. Sham has grown up and is scary and fantastic. Revenant Book 3 takes place 20 years into the future, making Sham an adult. Sham is out killing people for she is searching for Lori, her childhood best friend. Mason Goldspear is a crippled hunter and is half-Fu, making him as seen as someone strange and an excellent hunter in his own way. Mason's life as a hunter would change once he further descended to a maddening path, a roller coaster of uprisings and downfalls. Mason and Sham would cross paths and still on their own story and journey, but their interactions won't be the same as Sham and Revan's interaction. Both Mason and Sham as well aren't villains nor heroes, just like Magdiel and Nidia. So, Revenant Book 3 is about a woman searching for her best friend while killing lives for answers, and about a crippled half-Fu, both descending to a path of perpetual torment. There is a book 4 in Revenant, but I'd rather keep it a secret, for it is a surprise tool that will help us later. With all the characters in each book explained, it is time for the awaiting storyboard of book 1. So, drink water, eat a snack, sit down, and enjoy the video!
Why couldn't it follow the butterflies?
Who cares?
Thanks.
Oh, Harry.
Yes. Your home? Janissa.
Who are you?
I'm Sham.
Ah, a new face, are you? And an accomplished hunter, it would appear.
You'll be one of them, sooner or later.
But that was a lifetime ago.
Beg your pardon.
Hunters are held here to be sent on horrific hunts, their souls rotted by blood and madness. We've no need for this accursed abode. Let flame cleanse this house of horrors.
I believe they have a safe haven within the walls of this very city. A nest, if you will. 20 years of searching. Attack with 1,000 men.
As for us, the time has come to honor our vows. Hunters are needed no longer.
My duty, horrible as it was, I hope you will forgive me.
The way we've always said we'd end it, you recall.
I'll sweeten the deal for you.
So yeah, these are the storyboards I've made for Revenant. The storyboards were originally high school assignments, except for the character storyboards. The first storyboard contains 292 papers, the character storyboard contains 239 papers, and the book 1 storyboard contains 250 papers. I haven't finished writing Revenant though. Though to me is still upgrading my art skills and cleaning up potholes and adding further details for each books. I guess I'm proud of what I've made and will dedicate myself on finishing Revenant, turning it into a manga comic in the future! Thank you for watching, and have a good evening, good night, good morning, good noon, whatever day it is. Have fun, and see you later!
Thank you.